Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
It's a blessing to be able to do it.
Amen.
Some people would love to be able to push along with
and can't do it. I know that's right. That's why I don't even write.
Praise him anyhow.
Yeah, I'm most grateful that I have that he's given me the strength and the ability and the motivation to do it.
That's right.
Bless your holy name, Father. Bless your holy name. We come tonight to give you praise, Father. We come tonight to give you glory, Father. We come tonight to honor your name. Glory to your name. We worship your name, Father. Honor and thank you, Lord, not your son. Honor and thank you, Lord, not your king. Honor and thank you, Lord, not your son. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. You're so worthy, Father. You're so worthy. We give you praise, Father. We give you glory, Father. We give you honors. In the name of Jesus, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. We thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you for this day. Glory, 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 glory. And we thank you, Father, for yesterday's service. We thank you for the praise and worship, Father. Glory, glory, glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Glory, glory, glory. You're so worthy. You're so worthy. Glory, glory, glory. Bless you, Father. Bless you, Father. And we thank you tonight, Lord. We thank you tonight. We thank you, Father. We thank you for this day. We thank you for the praise and worship, Father. We thank you for all of our sisters and brothers, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you tonight for this Northside family. And we thank you especially tonight for our Monday night faithfuls. Glory, glory, glory. Glory to your name. The national championship game couldn't keep them at home. Glory, glory, glory. Basketball can wait. Harder to say, kid, about this young. Or let their kids about our day, kid. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. We thank you for everything you're doing in our lives. We thank you, Father, Father, for all the blessings, for all the grace, for all the victories. We thank you tonight, Father, for your great love. For your great mercy, we thank you, Father, for your healing powers. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you tonight for your peace, for the joy you've given us. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, Lord, in Jesus' name, we give you praise, we give you glory, we give you honor. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. You're so wonderful, Father. You're so wonderful. Orate kar, orate shan. Eberese kir, orate kin. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We say yes to you, Father. We say yes to you, Father. Glory, glory, glory. Let your will be done. Let your will be done. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Ora de cor varate sand. Ora se kir varate kind. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, glory, glory. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Harate kar varate sand. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Lord. You're so wonderful, Father. You're so wonderful. We stand on your word, Father, every day of our lives. Ora de kir varate sand. Your word is tried and true, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. Horate kor varate kind. Harase kir varate shund. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We thank you for the peace. We thank you for the joy. We thank you for the prosperity. Glory, glory, glory. Bless you, Father. Bless you, Father. Bless your holy name. Bless your holy name. Hora de kuar varate shan. Hora de kir varate kinde. Hora se kuar varate shan. In Jesus' name, Lord. In Jesus' name. Bless you, Father. Bless you, Father. We thank you, Father, for the service yesterday. We thank you for our pastors, James and Merlin Hill. Oh, God. Oh, God, what a blessing they are to us. Ora de kir varate shan. Ora de kuar varate kind. Ora de se kir varate shan. Glory, glory to your name. Glory, glory to your name. We give you praise, Father. We give you glory, Father. We give you honor, Father. In the name of Jesus. Ora de kar varate shan. Ora de kuar varate kind. Ora de se kir varate shan. In Jesus' name, glory to your name, glory to your name. And we thank you tonight, Father, we thank you tonight. Hora de kuar varate shan. Hibrede se kir varate kind. Hora de kuar varate shan. In Jesus' name, Lord, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, thank you, Father. We thank you, Father, we thank you for our lives, Lord. We thank you, Father, for our health. We thank you, Father, for our sound minds. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you, Father, for our substance. Glory, glory, glory. You are a provider. Hora de kir varate shan. Hibrede se kir varate kinde. Hora de kur varate shan. Glory, glory, glory. Our protector. Hora de kar varate kinde. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. We give you praise, Father. We give you glory, Father. We give you honor, Father. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Horate kuar varate shan. Ibrede se kir varate kinde. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, glory, glory. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Horate kir varate kinde. Horate se kir varate shan. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. We worship you tonight, Father. We worship you tonight. We worship you with our love, Father. We worship you tonight with our presence. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. We give you praise, we give you glory, we give you honor. In Jesus' name, Lord, in Jesus' name. And we thank you, Father, we thank you, Father. We thank you, Lord. Harate kuar varate shan. Ibrede se kir varate kind. Horate kuar varate shan. Harase kir varate kind. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. You redeemed us from the curse, Father. We've been redeemed. Glory, glory, glory. Porrete kid, Harvate kid, no weapons formed against us shall prosper. Harvate karabite kid, Porrete kur, Harvate shand, Porrete kid, Harvate kid, anywhere and everywhere we go, Harvate kar, Harvate shand, we wear our armor faith, glory, glory, glory. Porrete kid, Harvate shand, Everese kid, Harvate kid, glory, 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 glory. No fears, Harate karabite kid, no worries, Harvate kur, Harvate shand, no doubts, Harate karabite kid, glory, glory, glory. We lay all our cares at your feet. Harate karabite kid, Harate kur, Harvate shand, glory, glory, glory. We thank you tonight, Father. We thank you tonight. We thank you tonight. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. Amen, amen. Tonight, as we can get into some confessions, I purchased two of these confession books. I gave one to a young lady Saturday evening. She gave us on a birthday party out at an incredible pizza. Of course, my two J-Ton after dropped them off. Yeah, but she told me I didn't have to stay anymore. You know, I was rejoicing. Boy, that's a bad house out there. It's a bad house. But she's a single mom, about 31 years old. She's got a lot going for her. She has her own daycare. She goes to school 3 nights out of the week. She was running the aftercare at J-Town School and stuff. And she's a Christian. She goes, you know, to church regularly. And she's just a real pleasant person to be around. You know, the word said we should surround ourselves around people, you know, like ourselves. And she's one of the few people that I have a friendship with, you know, where we're spiritually connected. She came here a couple of times. Matter of fact, when we had the back to school rally, at the beginning of the school year, she came with her son, and he came to the shut-in that we had last summer, and she came to see Pastor Scales speak. So, you know, she really enjoyed that because I had given her, you know, some CDs. The services, and she wanted to really see him in person, so she got an opportunity to see him in person. But I gave one of these confession books, and I think I got about 4 or 5 of them out there. I have two in Dallas, and you know, this one and that, but I got about 2 or 3 around town here. So I try, you know, to put something in people's hands that I know that their ministry is, you know, is not provided for them. Because what we have here is rare. It's special. I can't think of anybody that do as much for its members as our pastors, you know, do for us, you know, providing us with so much material and stuff. And And, you know, and this, we just need to share it, you know, we're supposed to share it. And, but I haven't talked to her since I gave her this, but I'll be hearing from her, you know, pretty soon. I know she's probably gonna go through the whole, you know, book before I hear from her. My brother's girlfriend in Dallas, she takes hers to church, and she shares it with a congregation on Sundays. She'll read a couple of confessions or so each Sunday. And, you know, they really enjoy it down there. You know, so our pastor, you know, he's so anointed in these areas of putting material, scriptures, confessions, stuff in our hands. And I don't think anybody in town, you know, walk around and carry around as much material as we do. We probably put up more material than a lot of people have even seen, you know. So I'm really grateful, you know, for what they do, you know. Well, this is a word church, it's a teaching ministry. And we've been given plenty to feed on, you know. So I'm very blessed, you know, to be a part of this ministry and to let other people know, you know, what we're doing here. So hopefully I'm trying to win over from our church. It's probably not going to be easy because she said she grew up in our church. So, but that doesn't really matter, you know, about trying to win over here. Just giving her more information, you know, about the God we serve. So she was glad to have it. So I'm gonna read a confession, and after I read this one, some of y'all have something you wanna share with us. You're more than welcome. I'm gonna read Pleading the Blood and Binding the Enemy. It's on page 18. And if you don't have one, they probably brought her one from back there, but let's just be sure you put it back. Amen. Pleading the blood and binding the enemy. Father God, I plead the blood of Jesus over myself, my family, all my relatives and friends and their families, Northside Christian Center members and their families, partners and their families, all the ministries and businesses we are partners with, who are partners with us. Over all the residents, employees, employers, students, and those traveling in and out of Tulsa and its suburbs, over every major city and their suburbs in this nation, every town, village, and rural community, over every pastor, minister, apostle, prophet, evangelist, and teacher in this nation, their families, churches, ministries, and businesses, and over the entire body of Christ, their families, homes, businesses, and possessions. Satan, in the name of Jesus, I bind you and every principality, power, rule of darkness, spiritual hosts of wickedness in heavenly places, evil spirit, demon spirit, and every spirit that's not of God that has been operating against us. I counsel every hex, vex, spell, jinx, work of witchcraft, divination, black magic, psychic mind control, new age sorcery, and bewitchment sent to oppose us. I counsel every attack of oppression, depression, perversion, distraction, hindrance, and deception in Jesus' name. I render every assignment, attack, scheme, and harassment of yours, Lord, void, powerless, inactive, and often and ineffective against us in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. No weapon that is formed against us shall prosper. Every lying tongue is silenced, and every enemy that rises up against us is smitten before our face and flees before us 7 ways. I cast you out of our lives, homes, circumstances, finances, and neighborhoods. Your works have been destroyed, and we are free. Devil, everything you have stolen from us, I command you repay us now 7-fold. I speak life to every area of our lives that you have tried to destroy. I cancel all hurt, harm, danger, and accidents in our lives in the name of Jesus. I cancel all attacks against our families to bring strife, division, hatred, and rebellion. For God has given us peaceful habitations, safe dwellings, and quiet resting places, and we dwell together in unity. I cancel every attack of sickness, disease, pain, and infirmities sent against us. For Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, and with his stripes we are healed. I cancel every attack against the finances of God's church, for we are the seed of Abraham, and we are blessed above all nations of this earth. I call out the wealth of the wicked into the hands of the righteous, for money cometh to us now, in Jesus' name. I bind, rebuke, and cast out the spirits of fear, worry, doubt, anxiety, and unbelief, and give them no place in our lives. I pull down all strongholds and cast down every vain and wicked imagination exalted itself against the knowledge of God, and bring every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. I root up every plan in us that the Heavenly Father has not planted, and replace it with the image of God. I decree the spirit of power, love, and a sound mind establish our thoughts in the Word of God. I loose into our lives the anointing of God to destroy every yoke and remove every burden. The Word of God in our minds, our mouths, and our hearts, that God's kingdom will dominate the earth through us. We yield to the fruit of the Spirit and mortify the deeds of the flesh. I pray that the gifts of the Spirit will flow freely through our church to set the captives free and edify the church. And I decree that God's people are enjoying the days of heaven on the earth now. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. All right. These confessions are so timely. It definitely addresses everything that's happening in the world today. You know, all around us, all outside these doors, in our families, just all around us, just everywhere you turn. So I just really thank God and bless the house to be armed with these kind of weapons, because God's words are the most powerful weapons, we can have.
Yeah.
And I just have no fear. I have a word in a few years. I get concerned about things called, that's only natural, and human to be concerned, especially when it comes to our loved ones. But ultimately, I don't worry about it, because I know at some point, God is going to work it out for me. And I have no reason to doubt him, because he's worked out so much for me, in the 10 years that I've been, coming up on 10 years, that I've been a born-again Christian, and it being 10 years this Easter Sunday. So You know, when I look back before those 10 years, that what my life was like, where I was, and the state of mind I was in, you know, the physical condition that I was in, the mental condition that I was in. You know, I'm just overwhelmed and amazed that when you say these words and you take them to heart and you build on them and you believe them, and these words become life to you, you know, they become living words, and to see what they do in your life, the changes they make in your life, you know, it's just amazing. You know, I'm just still amazed, you know, at the, you know, how wonderful and merciful God is, and how much He loved me. So I'm just totally thankful. So, anyone have a confession they'd like to share? All right, go ahead. You want the mic?
Oh, no. I
think I can talk loud
enough. Okay, Father, I thank you for making total provision for all my needs, those in the past, those now, and those yet to come. Your gracious heart being disposed of showing favors is a demonstration of your great love, mercy, and care for me. As a father loves and pities his children, so that you love and pity those who fear you. You are my Lord, the faithful God, the Father of mercies, and the God of all comfort. And it is because of your kind nature and manifold mercies that we are sustained and not consumed. Great is your faithfulness. Thank you and bless you for all of your benefits. You forgive all my iniquities. You heal all of my diseases. You redeem my life from destruction. You crown me with loving kindness and tender mercies. You satisfy my mind for good things so that my youth is renewed like the eagles. Father, all that you have done and provided us have come through our Lord Jesus Christ. This was your plan before the beginning of time. Christ being willing to lay down his life before the world began is the reason why you could be so gracious and show us these mercies and such great kindness, which we see revealed through your compound names of Jehovah. In these names, your benevolent and compassionate heart is disclosed. Through these names, you have covenanted through your spirit to be. I like these. The Lord always with me, Jehovah Shammah. The Lord is my peace, Jehovah Shalom. The Lord my provider, Jehovah Jireh. The Lord is my banner, Jehovah Nissi. The Lord is my shepherd, Jehovah Rapha. The Lord is my righteousness, Jehovah Nikisi or something, I can't read his mouth. The Lord my position, Jehovah Rapha. Father, the things you have done for me have not been due to what I merit or good works which I perform, but because of your gracious and kind nature. You are full of compassion, ready to forgive, and plenteous in mercy. Because you delight in mercy, you are ever looking from one end of the earth to another to show yourself strong on the behalf of those whose hearts are trusting and relying upon you. Your desire to bless me and meet all my needs is more than I want to see my need met myself. Thank you for your unspeakable gift, Jesus Christ. Every good and perfect gift comes from above and comes down from the Father of lights, with whom is no barrenness, neither shadow of turning. You opened thine hand and loaded us with benefits and satisfied the desire of every living thing. For you are Lord over all, and is nigh and rich unto all that call upon you. To all that call upon you in truth, you are just willing to respond to my need. I mean, you are not just willing to respond to my need, but full of eager yearning. You are eagerly awaiting the opportunity to release your blessing on me in great profusion. It is when I receive from you and my prayers are answered and my needs is met that my joy is full. Your desire for me is that my joy be full. And as much as you did not spare your own son, but delivered him up for all of us, evidence enough for me to know that you are not a tight-fisted God who is in the business of withholding blessings from me. If you did not hold back your best, your son, you would not refuse to give me or hold back the rest. Because Jesus was offered up for us all and have become our merciful and faithful high priest, the reservoir of blessing has been enlarged and the fountain of blessings have become full to overflowing, causing your grace to be poured out and released into my life in great profusion. Father, I thank you and I bless you for your manifold mercies and for your abundant grace. Amen.
Amen. Brother Curtis, do you have a testimony or something you'd like to share?
Well, I have one, but good Lord, just tell me something I get up to.
Today had a moment with a person about this body of Christ. And I spoke about it yesterday. It seemed like the people just don't understand. I mean, I spoke on it yesterday about if your body hurt, one part of your body hurt, all of it hurt. And I would talk that every person in this church got a part of the body. Every person, from the least to the less. You know, if Sister Irene the eye, Brother Ryan could be the leg, Sister Pearl could be the arm, Sister Brown could be another leg, Sister Marianne could be another eye, Brother John could be the mind, Brother Travis could be, you know, another arm. You know, we all part of the body. Mm-hmm. But the key is, I'm telling you honest, the key is it's the love. That's the reason why the body is not together, because it's the love. And my assumption is the people think that, hey, if a certain person over something, I'm not going to deal with you. And I think it's just not right. If you in this church, the church will be here to heal whatever problem you have. I know I have many problems. I'm not perfect. And I'm trying to get there. I'm truly trying to get there, but I'll tell you how it is. We want to pick and choose our sin. If this is okay, I'm going to pick this for this day. The next day, I'm going to pick this. But God said, eat the whole, bro. We can't pick, I'm going to drink today and not drink tomorrow. I'm going to go out today and not go out tomorrow. He said, eat the whole, bro. If we're going to be right, we got to be right all the way across the board.
Right.
You know, if you see a brother in need, a sister in need, I bless people every day. It ain't a day I don't bless a person. But I don't mind. And I guess God put me in this type of position to bless people. I mean, I don't complain. I don't moan. I don't do anything. I just do it. Because simple reason, I know it's a need. And I know I'm going to get my return back. No, he said, don't look at yourself. Look at the next person need. Mm-hmm. What the next person need? You probably have what the next person need. And once you give that person that love and that whatever they need, hey, you never know what can turn around for that next person. But I was always taught this. The more you hold on, the more God gonna hold on from your blessing. But the more you pull out, the more God gonna put out. You know, we can say, hey, I don't care, I'm keeping mine. But at the same time, you got to remember this. The more you bless, the more God blesses you. Remember, he gave it to you. He blessed you. And he always said, if he give it to you, you bless someone else. Don't hold on to what God gave you. Bless someone else with it. And I was always taught that from my brother. You know, hey, if God give you something, go bless someone else with it. Go hold on to it. Why you holding on to it? What you going to do with it? Be selfish. We don't have to be selfish with what God bless us with. Go and bless someone else with. Because once you bless someone else, you're going to be blessed over more than that, what he bless you with. So I always ask myself, Lord, I know you gave me this decision to bless, but at the same time, don't let me have a heart where I'm stopped blessing people. I'm always going to continue to bless someone, always. I go in these homes and people do not have the money. They don't have the money. But I probably charge them. I'm going to put a small figure, $500. But before I leave out that house, I probably did over $800 worth of work. At least over $800 of work. But I don't complain. I get my money, go to the next house. The next house has the same problem. And mostly I deal with is females. Males don't call me on no work. Most of them is females. Mm-hmm. And the first thing they say, I need this, I need that. There's a woman today had her door kicked in. Didn't have the money. But I didn't put my head down and say, hey, you call somebody else, like, hey, it ain't nothing to me. I said, whatever you got to work with, let me work with you. You know, and that's what God look at us for. You know, because remember, that ladder you climbing up, waving at people, that ladder you have to come back down with. You got to wave with them when you come back down. So don't be the type that, hey, when you climb that ladder, you got to climb back down. So, as a body of Christ, this is what I'm saying. It got to be started with love first. When we got out of church yesterday, and I have to say this, I asked three people, no matter what, they said, I ain't coming, so I ain't giving nothing. I said, so, it's not none of your home, it doesn't matter, I'm not giving nothing. So, we can put that mask on when we get in this church house. But that mask coming off soon, we get out them doors. That's all what it is, a mask. And I'm going to tell the truth. I ain't going to sugarcoat it. We can put that mask on soon we get in the church house, laugh, do everything what we have to do. But soon we get out that church house, we're that person who we was before we walked in. And we're supposed to come in here to get healed. And I know I'm trying to get healed. And I'm not perfect, so I'm going to let you know right off the bat. I'm speaking because I'm trying to get my own self right. Well, Pastor Hill said this yesterday. I know what he said yesterday. He said, all the people in leadership position have to start coming to church. First thing did, it hit me. I said, that's me. I'm being honest with you. That's me. So that's why I made sure to come to church today. I got to make sure I come to man's meeting tomorrow. I ain't even coming. I got to make sure I do that.
It's not tomorrow.
The council.
I thought it was the third.
Okay. Well, I thought it was tomorrow, but whatever it is, I got to make sure I start making them. You know, Wednesday I got to start coming to Bible study. I ain't been coming, but I got to make time because if he say these things, we have to do it.
Yeah, that's right.
Especially the one who needs a simple decision. I don't want people to look at me. He do this, but he don't come to church.
Yeah.
I want to make sure I come to church, so don't want to have anything bad to say about me. But he's doing his job and he's doing what he's supposed to do. So I'm just saying, hey, we all have to start loving each other the right way. Not love me just only when I'm in this church out, but when you get outdoors, you don't love me. Love me when I'm in here and love me when I'm out there. God bless you.
Can I speak?
Amen.
For the person going over.
I'm not going over, you have a seat.
For myself. I think we have to be careful because first of all, the key word you said is love. And sometimes people are offended, they misunderstand because we're human. The main thing is when you deal with love and all things get an understanding. Because a lot of times we are assuming people are doing things for a negative reason. And maybe that person is just not bold enough to say, I just don't have $15, $20, $30, or whatever that may be. But the other thing is, I noticed what you said was that people sometimes, when a certain person is over something, they don't want to be involved. Mm-hmm. And I still say, we're still supposed to deal with that in love. The Bible says if you have fought against your brother and sister, or sister, you're supposed to get an understanding about it.
Right.
And I think that's the biggest part of where that love comes in. Because if we just go on and assume or make assumptions or what we think,